The National Academies of Sciences, Engineering, and Medicine have published their latest decadal survey of planetary science and astrobiology, revealing a recommendation that NASA prioritize the development of a flagship mission to Uranus, baseline to launch on SpaceX's Falcon Heavy rocket. Uranus, in-depth cloudy planet, hasn't been visited since Voyager 2 made a brief flyby back in 1986. And now SpaceX Falcon Heavy is the best ideal spacecraft for this important mission. Why is Falcon Heavy the best candidate instead of another American rocket? The mission proposal has been under development by a team of NASA, the University of California, and Johns Hopkins University scientists and engineers. For several years, according to its creators in its latest iteration, the Uranus orbiter and probe have the potential to fully answer 11 of 12 primary questions. The latest decade will survey structured itself around. Importantly, the survey indirectly states that if it weren't for the existence of one specific technology, it would have been a wash between a mission to Uranus or Neptune, and that keystone is SpaceX Falcon Heavy rocket. While the survey's authors don't explicitly point to SpaceX, in the context of you, they do state that a Uranus mission is favored, because an end-to-end mission concept exists that could be implemented in the 2023-2032 decade on currently available launch vehicles. As we know, in reality there only appears to be one launch vehicle, Falcon Heavy. Three other alternatives do technically exist: ULA Vulcan SimTower, Blue Origin's New Glenn, and NASA's own Space Launch System or SLS. However, there's factors to consider like delays, performance and such. Let's analyze NASA's Europa Clipper orbiter, originally manifested on SLS but later moved to SpaceX's Falcon Heavy, to avoid major launch delays, has helped demonstrate that SLS is not a viable for non-Artemis program missions, without massive productivity improvement and significant workarounds or design changes. Besides, while capable in many regards, Blue Origin's a usable New Glenn rocket, appears to have extremely poor performance beyond Earth orbit, well below what requires, and is unlikely to launch before 2024 or 2025. It's possible that an expendable New Glenn could suffice, but Blue Origin has never mentioned the option, and even then, the rocket's expendable performance could still fall short. Finally, ULA expendable Vulcan Centaur rocket has yet to launch, and its debut could easily slip way into 2023. More importantly, according to official information provided by the company to NASA, run performance calculator, even Vulcan's most capable variant, the VC-6, with six solid rocket boosters, or SRB, simply doesn't have the performance required to launch the Uranus orbiter and probe, which is 7,235 kilograms on seven of the missions. Preferred trajectories for three other secondary windows, Vulcan could potentially launch Uranus probe, but only with the inclusion of a Venus gravity assist that would require significant design changes to protect the spacecraft, while traveling much closer to the Sun, on the other side according to NASA calculator. A fully expendable Falcon Heavy rocket with a standard payload fairing, could launch around 8.5 to 10 tons to Uranus orbit preferred trajectories, leaving a very healthy margin for spacecraft weight gain or launch underperformance, and likely enabling a longer launch window for each opportunity. In addition, the SpaceX Falcon Heavy is one famous spacecraft in the present era of launches and missions, as it can accommodate heavy payloads and features itself to bring it to deep space. SpaceX Falcon Heavy is certified for even the most risk-averse NASA LSP, or Launch Service Program missions. In just the last 2 years, SpaceX has won contracts to launch NASA's Psyche Asteroid Explorer. That was August 2022, the Viper Moon River in quarter 4 of 2023, the Gusser GOES-U weather satellite in quarter 2 of 2024, the Europa Clipper in quarter 4 of 2024, and the PPE and Halo modules of the Gateway Lunar Space Station in quarter 4 2024. Last month, SpaceX's Falcon Heavy was also said to likely launch the NASA telescope, after ULA skipped the competition, named after Nancy Roman, who played a foundational role in the creation and launch of NASA's famous Hubble Space Telescope. The Roman Space Telescope could potentially be the second most expensive NASA spacecraft launched this decade. As a result, SpaceX's Falcon Heavy rocket is all but guaranteed to win the contract to launch the Uranus mission. Well, this is a big cake of space. However, did Elon Musk confirm involvement in the project? When will this happen? Don't let people down. Elon Musk replied to a tweet regarding this new project from NASA, and the newly released decadal survey, which confirms SpaceX's involvement in the project. The tech CEO said that it had to be done, and it may refer to the mission plan involving the Falcon Heavy, for the Uranus mission. If NASA agrees with the survey's conclusion, and decides to develop the Uranus orbiter and probe, and also plans on the Academy's optimistic assumption, of a less than 18% budget increase. On average from 2023 to 2032, work towards a preferred 2031 launch window, could begin in earnest as early as 2024. Compromised of a namesake orbiter and probe UWP would arrive in orbit around Uranus, in late 2044, or early 2045 weighing around 5 metric tons. The primary science mission would begin by deploying a small atmospheric probe, to directly analyze the composition and behavior of the planet's exotic atmosphere, which is believed to be volatile, prone to the vast and violent storms, and host to some of the most extreme winds in the entire solar system. The probe would weigh 270 kilograms, and is only expected to survive for a few hours at most. The orbiter, however, would continue on to tour the Uranian system for at least 4 years, observing and studying the ice giant and its rings, its magnetosphere and 27-plus moons. Uranus itself resides in what may be the most common class of exoplanets in the universe, making a close study of it is invaluable for exoplanet science as a whole. It's also possible that like several moons around Saturn and Jupiter, one or more uranium moons have liquid water oceans created by tidal heating. Adding to the list of extraterrestrial bodies that might feature habitable environments or alien life. There's several mysteries around Uranus that a mission could solve. What causes it to be tilted practically sideways? Why are its magnetic fields unlike any other planet in the solar system? And what is the origin of its medium-sized moons after all? The important question is, will this decadal survey mission happen? To be honest, decadal surveys are a bit tricky. They aren't really guidelines so much as recommendations which Congress, the President, and NASA can opt to take up and fund. Or ignore, but several survey recommendations made in the past have become full-scale NASA missions today. So the survey has a fair amount of weight and is always what we get done. Will depend on whether the planetary science budgets do better than keeping pace with inflation. SpaceX is ready, but NASA has much more to consider. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.